They may not be actual royalty, but the Kardashian family is its own empire at this point. Even the littlest and cutest members of this family have to obey a shocking set of rules. Find out just what it takes to be a child member of the Kardashian family. But first, make sure you're subscribed for the latest from the taco. Now, on to the rules. Nannies. Since they're busy running a social media empire, as well as constantly coming up with new business ideas, the Kardashian parents need a little bit of help. So, naturally, the littlest members of the Kardashians have nannies. But they need to learn how to keep them in line. When a main member of the Kardashian family, especially Kim, is strolling down the street, all nannies need to fan out behind her in a V formation. After all, they don't want to steal any of the spotlight away. The kids also keep their nannies on their beck and call. And it's expected that they'll always be available if the kids demand their attention. Oh, and the nannies are also expected to help take care of the four-legged members of the Kardashian family as well. In addition to looking after the children. And as a Kardashian kid, you have to always make sure you outshine those around you. Kim Kardashian was robbed a few years ago and has been a little nervous since. She insists that her nannies refrain from wearing jewelry so as not to make themselves targets when out and about with the family. Modeling. The adult Kardashians are no strangers to being brand ambassadors, whether for their own products or someone else's. And whether the kids like it or not, they're expected to wear what they're told and pose for photos in it as well. Just because Northwest is a little girl doesn't mean she gets a pass on helping out with the family business. As her parents, Kim Kardashian and Kanye West, work on their kids' clothing line, Northwest models in their latest looks. She has to smile for the camera while her famous mom films videos to share online. Naturally, just like the other Kardashians, the kids don't just get to sit back and have photos taken. North is already working to help pick out her own clothing and outfits. We're sure it's only a matter of time before she launches her very own clothing line. Screen time. Just like non-famous parents, the Kardashian family worries about their kids having too much screen time. Kourtney Kardashian waited until her kids were at least two before allowing them access to electronic devices. Nowadays, she does allow them to play video games and watch television, but on a very limited basis. The kids get a half an hour of screen time on weekdays and an hour on the weekends. And the screens definitely aren't allowed to be brought out during meals or other times when the family could be communicating with one another. Social media. Interacting with social media is a part of life as a Kardashian, and the kids get an early start. While how many YouTube videos they can binge watch is limited, it's important that they learn how to create their own content. One way that Kourtney Kardashian has her kids interact with social media is through YouTube videos. Her daughter Penelope likes to make tutorials about how to make slime and then upload them for her followers to enjoy. Kim Kardashian feels similarly when it comes to her children. She even let her daughter North post a photo she snapped of Kim, although many people felt it was too risky. It seems par for the course when it comes to life as a Kardashian. Kim acknowledges that social media is more important than ever and says that her children need to learn about building their brand. Hand-me-downs. Although they certainly aren't hurting for money, Kardashian kids are expected to wear hand-me-down clothing, just like the rest of us. Even though her kids have different styles, Kourtney says that her kids are required to wear hand-me-downs from their older siblings. Kim is also big on the idea of hand-me-down clothing and says that it's a must for her kids as well. Although the kids all have their own unique senses of style, Kourtney and Kim claim that their wardrobes are so large, it's possible to find secondhand clothing from a sibling that matches the look they're going for, and they aren't afraid to stray from gender-specific clothing either. Kourtney says that she'll dress daughter Penelope in Mason's old blazers and loafers, just to mix things up a little. Those clothes are so expensive, it makes sense that they should be used for more than just one child. Visitors. Even though Stormy is just a baby, mom Kylie Jenner already has some rules that she has to follow. Or, more accurately, rules that anyone visiting her must follow. It seems that first-time mom Kylie is a bit of a germaphobe when it comes to her daughter. She prefers that visitors come to her because she hates taking Stormy out into uncontrollable and possibly dirty environments. Kylie is serious about keeping her daughter healthy and thinks that keeping her at home is the best way to do so. Hopefully, Kylie will ease up a little in the future, since isolating babies is usually not necessary unless they have some sort of medical condition. And when guests do visit, she makes them wear medical masks just to make sure they don't breathe any germs on her precious daughter. Bedtime. Beauty sleep is important to the Kardashian family, and different parents have their own way of making sure their kids get theirs. Kourtney forces her kids to put down their iPhones and iPads and pick up some books. They read together as a family before it's time for lights out. The kids can relax under a projector that displays stars on the ceiling while they fall asleep. They also get to doze off while listening to lullabies. Meanwhile, at Kim's house, things are a little bit different. With the recent addition of Little Chicago, it's more important than ever that North and Saint have a strict strict bedtime routine. They get to pick out their own pajamas, and then it's off to bed after a quick story from their mom. Kim believes that having them go to bed at a set time every night helps them adjust to their changing lives. Microwaves. With her love of modern conveniences, it seems strange that there's one standard kitchen appliance that Courtney's kids are forbidden to use: the microwave. When she was pregnant with Mason, she read about toxins from plastic containers being transferred to food cooked in the microwave instead of just sticking with glass. She decided that she couldn't trust having a microwave in her home. So if her kids want something hot, it has to be heated up on the stovetop or in the toaster oven. She also worries that microwaves will leach nutrients from the food, and because they don't always cook evenly, they may end up burning the kids on something that's too hot. Instead, she's quick to sing the praises of her handy toaster oven, which she says has never let her down. Diets. If you're wondering where Kourtney Kardashian's kids heat up their Hot Pockets with no microwave, don't worry. Those aren't allowed either. Her kids must follow a diet so strict, it would make a number of grown adults flinch. They're required to eat food that is both dairy and gluten-free, despite not being allergic to either. Mom Kourtney says that she believes it makes them behave better, and even packs them gluten and dairy-free cupcakes and treats when they head out to a birthday party. Kim Kardashian's kids also have to follow a strict diet. All of their food must be organic and free of any sugar. You won't find any processed food in the kitchen at Kim's house. Both Kourtney and Kim deny that they're worried about their kids' waistlines, and instead say that they're just focused on their health. Even their baby foods are homemade to make sure that they're as healthy as possible. Banned materials. It's not only microwaves that Kourtney's kids are forbidden to use. To say that Kourtney is a little obsessed with health is an understatement. We can't fault her for doing her best for herself and her kids, but we sure wouldn't want to live with some of these requirements. In addition to understandable and predictable rules like no soda, Kourtney has also outlawed cotton pillowcases. She believes that only silk pillowcases prevent wrinkles, so that's what she insists her family use. Kourtney has another strange kitchen rule that her kids must follow: no plastic. She only uses glass or stainless steel because she's afraid of a chemical called bisphenol A, which is sometimes found in plastics. She believes that it contributes to major health problems like diabetes or cancer, and that's a risk she definitely doesn't want to take for herself or her kids. Parenting styles. Members of the Kardashian family might tease each other frequently, but Kourtney admits there is one parenting decision that caused her family to label her insane. She practices attachment parenting, and not only allows, but encourages her children to sleep in bed with her. This has been going on since she was with their father, Scott Disick, and Kourtney says that it just feels right to her. She never researched attachment parenting until she realized that was what she was already doing. Although Kim and Kourtney have similar parenting styles in many ways, this is one area where they hugely differ. Compared to her sister, Kim describes her parenting as really strict. She loves to play with her kids, but when it's time for naps or bedtime, she is all about structure in terms of both timing and making sure the kids are in their own beds. Smoothies. It's been a while since Kourtney Kardashian had to make her kids baby food, but this crunchy mom has still figured out a way to blend her kids up something healthy. Having Kourtney as a mother means that you'd better start liking smoothies, because they're going to be a big part of your life. Like most moms, Kourtney wants to make sure that her kids get the right amount of vitamins and nutrients. However, she doesn't want to rely on over-the-counter supplements, because she doesn't trust them. Instead, she makes up her own special blends for her children that she believes will improve their health. To help out with their nutritional needs, she has them drinking green smoothies and protein shakes. It's pretty brilliant, since many kids who would shun green veggies will happily drink a shake. She also adds some MCT oil, bone broth protein, probiotics, and flaxseed for some extra health benefits. Quality time. Another way that Kim and Kourtney differ is their definition of quality time. Kim is not afraid to drag her kids to places that most parents wouldn't dare take their kids. When North was just under 2 years old, she was sitting in the front row at New York Fashion Week. Sure, her dad was on stage, but should a two-year-old really be at such an event sitting next to Beyoncé and Anna Wintour? Apparently not, since North threw a tantrum at some point. Kourtney, on the other hand, isn't a fan of strict schedules. She prefers to let the day take her wherever it leads, and focuses on more kid-centric activities. Sure, work calls her away at times, but on those occasions, she leaves the kids with trusted nannies. When she spends time with her kids, she wants her focus to be on them. While it's too early to commit on Kylie's parenting, many fans suspect that based on her frequent social media posting, she might be relying pretty heavily on a nanny at this point. Future rules. Though she's currently still pregnant with her first child, Khloe Kardashian has already come up with plenty of rules for her daughter. When asked if her child would be allowed to watch Keeping Up with the Kardashians, she said not until she's at least 13. She admitted that she doesn't think the show is appropriate for young children, and her own child is no exception. That's sort of sweet, but sort of strange, considering that the show is basically the Kardashian version of home movies. We wonder if Keeping Up with the Kardashians will still be on television in 13 years, or if she'll have to watch it on Netflix. Privacy. It seems like Kim Kardashian doesn't keep much about her life private, and apparently she expects the same from her children. She's said that she has a lot to teach them about social media, but that doesn't mean she's ready to send them off on their own. When she decides that they're old enough to have their own social media accounts, she'll need to have their passwords. Kim revealed that when Kylie and Kendall were kids, Kim, Khloe, and Kourtney would access their accounts and spy on them, of course reporting all their findings to their mother, Kris Jenner. Strangely, Kim said that this helped her bond with her sisters, and she looks forward to spying on her own children someday. Do you think you could live with this set of rules? What about giving up your microwave? Let us know your thoughts on being a member of the Kardashian family in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe for more from The Taco. Bye for now!